Hey everybody, welcome back. I am going to continue my drawing of Taylor Swift now. It's going to be done with colored pencil. I'm probably going to finish up with some oil paint on top, and it's going to be a step-by-step tutorial. Sorry I had to leave before, but I wanted to wait until my kids went to bed so that I could spend some time with them. So thanks for the understanding with that. I'm going to be checking the questions a lot more as well during this one, but I'm ready right now. Here we go. See that some viewers are coming in. Welcome. This is a continuation of the drawing that I did before in part one. I put it as a private video temporarily because I didn't want people to think that I was finished. I have more work to do. I'm only about maybe 30% done with it. So I'm good for a few hours tonight. So stay as long as you want. I will be checking questions. So if you want, you could leave some comments and I will answer them soon as I take a break from the drawing. I'm going to be really focused, so I don't know how much narrating I'm going to be doing, but hit me up with those questions and I will, I'll definitely answer them in time. Sorry about the glare. I know it looks like something was spilled on it, but it's just the shininess of the colored pencil. Okay. I'm going to assume that the people who are here now were not here before. Started out with the pencil drawing from my step-by-step, and then I went in with a layer of markers, and now I'm going over the markers with the colored pencil. The hair is really important in this one. I definitely prefer doing hair with colored pencil. It's a lot more fun. Regular pencil, just not fun anymore. Wow, I see we already have 10 people. Welcome back if you were here before. And welcome if this is the first time that you're joining. These are really handy. This is, it's called a Prismacolor art stick. And admittedly, right now it looks like poor Taylor had a stroke or she's drunk or something. It'll get better in time. Every drawing reaches an awkward phase. That's where we're at right now with mine. All these Prismacolor art sticks are, it's a colored pencil that is in the shape of a pastel. But it's the same mixture as a regular colored pencil. Same mixture meaning pigment and wax, same formula that they use. And tonight I'm gonna probably finish this off with oil paint. I always do the step-by-step tutorials in pencil because I know that's a tool that almost everybody has, but this is really my preference of materials to work with. And I think I'm going to do more of this, actually. I never want to make people, you know, go out to the store and spend extra money. You know, and especially in these economic times, but, you know, like I always say, I was forced to take an art class to graduate college. Turned out to be a pretty darn good thing for me. And some things are just investments. You know, art supplies, you know, it's something that does the world good, so. I'm going to check questions in a moment. So if you guys have questions, please put them in. gray is the most underused color in flesh tones. It cuts the chroma, which is the intensity of the color. Very important, especially with paint. All right, let me go to some comments. Fourteen people are with us. Mene Lupe, you're back. Welcome back. First, wow, great to see you. Took my ideas into consideration. Yes, I did. I like to listen to people. It's important. Are you going to make an edited version of this, like a normal step-by-step video? Because I would love to draw this, but I missed the first part. Yes, I actually have the step-by-step done already. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to merge this together. And you gave me an idea. Oh, let me put the volume down. You gave me an idea. What I'm going to do is for the people who have just regular pencils, I'm going to do a black and white version. I'm going to turn this into a black and white version. Hold on. Yeah, sorry, had to turn off the volume. There's also going to be a step-by-step with this version as well. So I'm thinking two step-by-steps. Hakeem Irving is back. Hey, welcome. Thank you. He says, nice. Shadow Kitsune Princess, it looks beautiful. Thank you so much. Do you use a computer sketchpad too? I got to work on that. That's what I really, that's my New Year's resolution, even though it's not New Year's yet. By the end of 2015, I want to get comfortable, with using either a tablet or, some device that could be used on the computer. It could even be computer screen. Hakeem Irving, you said you were forced to take an art class in college. So you never did before? Well, I say I never took an art class before. I took art in high school, and I was underwhelming, at it. We never had drawing. We would always do, like, these crafty projects. And I don't know. I'm not a very crafty artist. I like to draw. I like to be creative, and I've certainly branched out since then. But I went to a liberal arts school, and in order to graduate there, I had to take either a music or an art class. All right. I think that's all the comments for now. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to get back to work, but I'm just going to, I'll check back in a few minutes. So if you guys have more questions, just, go right ahead. I'm on a mission right now. Before was like worst case scenario. I just had, I had to find a quiet place. So I went up and did it in a very uncomfortable place, but got some progress done. Believe it or not, I'm going to use some blue in the hair. She's a blue-haired little old lady. It's actually the color of reflections because of the sky. So I'm going to merge the blue with the white on top of the yellow from the marker. It should look okay. And go over it, touch it up a little bit with oil paint. I'm not going to do too much with oil paint. Not going to like remake it, but just like bring out the highlights. You see the difference. Oh, you guys can't even see on the screen. Yeah, great. Difference here versus here. You know, we're going to build that. I'm going to be here a while, so if you guys want to just come back, I totally understand. But, you know, I'm going to be here probably at least until 10:30. I do have work tomorrow, and I want to be fresh for that, but I want to do this too. Hold on. I love colored pencils because you could blend on the surface, do some really cool stuff. Say 35% done. I don't know what I'm talking about. It's done when it's done. Just saying, you guys who are watching are cool. Just saying. You know, I love it. It shows you want to learn, and I will do my darndest to make sure that you, you know, have all of your questions answered, and, you know, I will be giving my best on this. I'm going to check comments again in another 2 minutes or so. But this is coming along. I think while you're waiting, you guys should all get to know each other in the comment section. It's always good to have somebody that, you know, kind of goes, how do I say this? Cartoon Block. I've known him since I started my channel. We were like less than 10,000 subscribers together. And it's just nice to go on a journey with somebody, you know? Even if you wind up getting your butt kicked. All right, let me get to those questions. What is that glossy finish? Oh, I do not mean to have the glossy finish. Let me show you something. I have a light on this and it, hold on. Yeah, there we go. So basically, whatchamacallit, with the light, it creates that glare, but it also helps me see. And the fluorescent lights, when you're making a video, you don't want to have fluorescent lights. It kind of changes the lighting for the worse. Although looking at this now, it actually looks decent, but it always seems to render the wrong way. Let me take a look again. Hold on. It kind of looks more, a lot more orangey than it does in real life, looking at it right now. I'll scan it. I'll show you what it looks like at the end. Cameras always distort. But, when I took that off, you see the glare is gone, that shiny finish. But, but it's orange. It's like she's got jaundice. Whatchamacallit? Let me get to the next question. Oh man, they just flew in. Yeah, is it because of wax-based pencils or something? Yes. Thought you used water for a moment. Right. Yeah. Also, would love to know what camera and setup you use. I bought a camera years ago because I wanted to do something like this too, but it turns out I can only record 10 minutes at a time. Okay. I will show you. Let me switch to webcam. And you guys will have to be like, instead of like, ew, you say something nice. Oops, what did I just do? Okay. There I am. Hello. Okay, check this out. So this is called the Elmo projector. They have these in schools. I borrowed mine from my school. I actually have a video on my setup, my regular setup. But what this thing does is it's got a swivel, and you could kind of like, look down on what you're drawing. So I think these cost like $150. You can special order them at Best Buy. Okay. So let me go back. I don't know why they call them Elmo projectors. Elmo! I can't escape Elmo. Let me get back to those questions. The App Stop. Just wanted to say hi. Hi, App Stop. Is the shininess in the face from the paper or the medium that that you had used? Yeah, combination of the light and the media. Stephen Bostick. What's up, Stephen Bostick? Fluffy Panda 126 is back. Welcome back. And let me see. No, that's okay. Sorry, I know I write a lot, but I really like how you use markers. That's the reason I subscribed years ago. No, that's fine. I like answering questions, and the whole purpose of me being here and doing it this way is so that I could answer questions. I haven't done enough, especially over the last year, interact. So, now we do it. Keep asking those questions. Love answering them. Let me see if I missed anything. If not, I will get back to work. Let me refresh just to make sure. Wow, thank you guys for the 17 likes. Mr. Magic King, no, I missed it. What do you mean? You're here. You didn't miss anything. I recorded everything. Okay. I know the light might get annoying. Why don't you guys tell me, you prefer it with the light or without? The light that gives the glare. So it's either jaundice orange or the light. Let me before I go back, let me just read what you guys have to say. Thank you, Mr. Magic King 101. So just write light or no light, and I'll wait another 30 seconds or so. Sometimes there's a delay. Hot Pink 89727 is back. Welcome. All right. No, nobody's commenting about the light. So let me get back to work. I'm just going to get back to work. I'm going to put the light on because it helps me. And I'm going to get back to work. So right now it's not tied together. You see different splotches of color on the face. I'm going to let the paint tie it together. I think within the next, 30 minutes or so, we're going to go with the paint. Want to finish the hair. And I want to tie it a little bit more with the colored pencil. never took a color pencil class. I know that was random, but I think that's why I like mixing them with paint, because that's my biggest comfort zone. She's got cool hair. Just saying. You know what we could do? If you guys are sketching right now, let me quickly put in my email address. Hold on. And what you guys can do, if you want, I'll shout out some of your work. And show it in this video. Byroneus C says, do what you like. That's a good one. That's like one of my jokes. Right on, man. Good job. I want to see Interstellar. Magic King 101. No one's checking your spelling here. It's okay. Ryan Mandel, welcome. Very old drawings from my videos. I always get a kick out of, you know, seeing those. So absolutely. Yeah. Send them. Want to see those. Right on. I guess I've been doing this a while. That's cool, though. No, it's awesome to see those. I like totally dorked out once because I went to a school that I did an observation at. And on the walls were the stuff done from my videos, and I didn't know what to say to people. I mean, nobody recognized me when I came in. I mean, people recognized the hand. No, I'm just kidding. You know, it was the coolest thing. I love seeing the work that you guys do from the videos. So if you want to send that, we will definitely do that. I want to get a little bit further along because I want to be able to get the paint out, but I don't know, maybe in like 15 minutes. All right. So let me get back to work, get the rest of this hair, then we touch it up with some paint. Looks like she's got like bruising on the cheek. We'll fix that. Sorry, Taylor. My bad. And before I forget, thank you guys for watching. Now you see, I think I went too far out here, but I could always go over it with the pencil. If that doesn't work, and it's not going to, that's where the paint comes in. And let's say the paint doesn't work. Guess what? Scissor, cut it out, paste it down something else. Always a way to fix things. Kind of evil hairstylist, paper curls like that, man. Come on. It's not fair. Some of us have to draw here. I would have cried if it was just regular pencil. Not cool. Turn the light off. Prismacolor pencils are a good investment. I mean, I can't say I enjoy paying $1 or $2. They're $1 per pencil, but they're worth it. I think I'm going to draw Mark Crilly next week. What do you guys think? It's been long overdue. I don't know if you guys were subscribed at this time, but I had made a petition so that YouTube makes a category for artists to upload art videos. because I kind of think of YouTube as a museum. I went around to different YouTube artists and asked them for their support. He made a video about that. Really cool guy. As did Cartoon Block, as did Psychra. We never got a category. Darn YouTube. That's all right. It's kind of not cool that we have to upload videos into like how to in style. Come on. That's just silly talk. That line there is where I'm going to cut the hair. Hey, 20 viewers. Cool. If you missed it, I put my email address in. And if you want to show some of the work that you've done, that you do or have done, go right ahead. I will shout it out in this video. A little bit more with the hair. Hold on. People have correctly pointed out with me a tendency that I have on the right side of the hair. I get lazy. I really do. And they're right. Tonight, I'm not getting lazy though. Almost forgot about the bling. Bling. All right, the likeness is starting. The paint will take it to another level. as paint always does. Even if I do go like really, really digital someday, I always see myself continuing to work with paint. All right, let's get to those emails. Okay. Cool. Laney's 101. Peace sign. Cool. I'm so honored that you saved them. That is so cool. Thumbs up. The mouth. That was my first video that got over 100,000 views. I was like, whoa. Cool. Thank you so much for sharing. And I see you did several of these also. That's a great effort. That's what gets you good. And here's Chelsea. Oh, Napoleon Dynamite, the legend. That is really well done. That is so cool. I kind of like yours better than mine. Oh, this is perfect. Wow. Holding hands. I think somebody put a wise comment in that it's like, yeah, they're holding hands, but their wrists were chopped off. I was like, geez, somebody came out of a bad relationship. That's so cool. Praying Hands by Albrecht Dürer. So this was considered one of the great drawings of the Northern Renaissance. And wow, look at the veins. I see that there's some glare factor here in yours too, but I can see that you really got the veins of the hands. That's a tough one. Good job. Got some serious talent, Chelsea. You like drawing hands, unlike the rest of the world. I guess I got to make some more hand videos. All right. Both of you guys did the hand videos. Yeah, I got to do more hand videos. Everybody requests the middle finger. I'm like, that's just wrong. Cool. Thank you guys for sharing that. And hopefully, here we go. Yep, came back. All right. Let me look at the comments. Yeah, Mr. Magic King 101 totally agrees with me. Looks awesome. Got a smile from Hakeem Irving. Walking Dead. Everybody loves The Walking Dead. Go watch The Walking Dead. I understand. Don't worry. I'll probably be drawn by the time you're done, or actually painting. Wow, still 15 people watching despite The Walking Dead. I feel special. And 29 likes. Thank you, guys. Yep, got to do more hand videos. All right, so what I'm going to do right now, it's going to seem like a break, but not going to take a break. I'm going to get my paint ready because I'm going to paint and finish this off. Excuse me. So I'll be back in a few moments. I'm going to keep it streaming. I'll just be getting the paint. All right, let's get this party started again. So, let me see. I'm out of the palette paper sheets, so I'm just going to use aluminum foil. I have some painting medium. Let me turn on the light. Is it on? No. There we go. Have some painting medium. And just very narrow range of colors. I think I'm going to do the opposite of what I did. I'm going to do the hair first, and then I'm going to work my way back into the face. Now I'm going to use opaque colors for the hair. I just pulled a Van Gogh, by the way. What I mean by that is some of my paint hasn't been used in a while because, you know, my break. I had to open up a tube of a color that I needed. So I do what any guy would do. I bit into it. I bit the cap, and problem was there was some paint on the cap, and it just kind of like, moral of the story is I just ate some paint. So it was an earth color, so there's nothing toxic in there, but still, that was interesting. All right, so I took yellow ochre, and the color that I'm using now is kind of like a mixture between yellow ochre and white. Here we go. You see how it's opaque and it could go right over it? Create those highlights. Watch this. So cool. And I could even go brighter. Take some titanium white. And let's find a highlight and create it. Here we go. So it calls for a highlight to be here. That's too bright. My process has kind of evolved out of need, and I've gotten used to it. Paintings take time, but if you do the colored pencil first, and the marker first, it kind of like, it's a way that you could like paint in a day. Let me show you what I mean. We're just going to get rid of that extra hair. See ya. That's what I love about paint. How cool is that? Fro no more. What I could do is I can pull this down. Over this area and here. And there's some texture in here. It gets a little bit darker in there. So let me go back with the dark. And if you put it on thin, you'll be able to see the lines that I left underneath. So it's not like the work is for nothing. I use several brushes when I paint, usually one to apply, one to smudge, stretch, whatever you want to call it. And I mean, colored pencils are made of the same thing. So let's say that you wanted to like put in, watch this, individual strands of hair. You could do that. you see how the black is seeing through here? Now it's not overpowering. And for details, you could use the colored pencil. Especially a black colored pencil. I'll take some questions again in about 2 minutes. Just want to get a little bit more of the hair done. But I consider myself a mixed media artist. I was trained as a painter, but if you limit yourself, you are just being silly. I've used this process to do other self-portraits and other portraits. Like if you Google my name, you know, you'll see some of my work. I think the one I'm most proud of is the portrait that I did of my mother. And I kind of did it in a similar way, using colored pencils, using, you know, all of the tools that you potentially could use. Might want to check that out. I mean, this is just kind of like a one-day study that I'm doing. But that one I like pushed for a long time. So I could come back the next day, I could do colored pencil right over this and, you know, start again. All right, so now to finish this, finish the hair, the face isn't done yet. I'm gonna take a totally soft brush that has no paint on it. And I'm gonna try to, of course, look at the reference image, but smooth it out. Neutralize it. And all of the layers that we did before with colored pencil, you know, helps us out here. So anything that stands out too much, I'm going to try to push down. Anything that needs to be redefined, you know, we could redefine it. And let's turn off the light. Okay, somewhat happy with the hair. Might do a little bit more, but let me get to those questions. Just curious, isn't hair easier to render if it's done as hatching? Well, you get the individual strands, but I don't know. I guess it's a difference of style or a difference of preference. I like getting the individual strands, and if you look, you could still see some of them, but I think it gives you the depth with the painting. Mr. Magic King, thank you. Whoa, looks awesome. Oh, that wasn't at me. That was at the other ones. Oops, I'm still in somebody's compliment. I'm such a jerk. Sorry. J. Mark Guy, thanks for keeping it real. He doesn't watch Walking Dead. Kai doesn't watch it either. Welcome, Kai. Minnie Lupe, that's really good, and she's hot. Beepity beep. LOL. Cool. All right. Still got 11 people watching. If you guys have questions before I go on to the face, let me know right now. Thank you for the 35 likes. And then I'm going to go on to the face. And maybe it'll be done tonight. I don't know. Might give it one more go around. But I'm liking how this is developing. Let me give you guys another second if you have a question. Or maybe I'm just putting you guys to sleep. All right, I'm going to go get some more paint. I will be right back. All right, I'm back. Mr. Magic King 101, Merrill, is it good to trace drawings? I have a joke about that, but the joke has a point. I always tell my students, if you don't consider tracing, you should call it tracism. And trace, you know, racism isn't good, so tracism definitely isn't good. Sometimes you need it. Think of like Banksy, who makes stencils. That is a lot of it, not all of it, is tracing. And Chuck Close, who does super photorealistic stuff, he also admittedly, traces. Have I ever traced? Absolutely. Let me see. Alice Luo, oh, thank you so much. Seems like a dumb question, but think about it. Do you think it could be beneficial at all? Yeah. Jay agrees with me. Magic King 101, yeah, it's no problem. It's a shortcut, though, to learn to draw. That's a good point. I'm better off following thank you, or use a grid. What I don't like about it, I'll say, is you don't get the stylized likeness. I mean, this is something that like only my hand can do. It's unique to my hand. It's not photorealism, but it's unique to my hand. If I had traced it, it wouldn't have that. But in some projects, why not? All right, let's start working on that face. Everybody loves Taylor Swift, so hope I don't screw it up. But if I do, there's always a way to fix it. And here's where I'm going to do some very subtle, stuff. I always say break things down into shapes. Now we are thinking about edges, edge quality, transitions, one area to the next. What's going to happen? And here's where the layer before becomes like really important. Oh, wow, look at that glare. Okay, maybe I won't use. Hold on. There we go. So I basically mixed a medium opacity skin tone. Opacity, for those of you who don't know, it's just basically how thick something is. So for instance, a window is transparent, glass of a window is transparent, but a wall is opaque. I'm doing something in between. Oops. Yeah, I'm doing something in between. translucent. I want to be able to see the layer underneath, or I want the layer under the colors underneath the colored pencil to blend. But I want to smooth things out. I'm going to zoom out a little bit. And I'm applying with a very small brush, but I'm going to put the detail in with the, I'm going to smooth out with the bigger brush. Just like that. And you see how that softened what I did before? I'm going to add a little bit of white to this and reconsider those highlight areas again. And it's those little details. Not only do you put the tone in, you put the shape in. And you consider the edges of the shape. There we go. I'm pulling it back because you can't really see. And this is done on paper, by the way. It's bleed-proof illustration paper. Delicately adding the shadows. Giving her a beard. Just kidding. Yeah, paint is an amazing invention. I mean, at least with me, other mediums, it, I don't know, agitates me a bit. This, even though there's like people watching me from wherever you guys are, it's calming me. Paint makes me happy. And it has that effect on a lot of people. Something spiritual about it, I think. Just saying. You can't really see the details that I'm adding. I see on this camera, unless if I pull it back, but it's just trying to round the face, shape it a little bit. I think I'm going to go back into the hair now. I haven't done enough painting videos, and I want to give you guys a good demonstration of what paint can really do. Brush is just a tool that you use to shape what you want, such as this highlight. You know, the question before was like, for doing the hair, is it easier to do with something with a fine tip? I would say, actually now, no, because you could have a brush with a fine tip, or you can have, this is a flat brush, you could have a rounded brush. I just think it's easier with paint. Gonna have to do something different about the lipstick. Sorry about the glare. Ugh, just looks so orange. Whenever that light is not on. Not in real life, but on the camera, I mean. I'm going to check for questions in a minute or so. So if you guys have a question, just go for it. All right, chicken comments. Alice Lowe, it looks finished to me. Blitz liked my beard joke. Yeah, I gave her a beard. Why not? It does, but watch becomes... That's a lot of pressure, Mr. Magic King, but thank you. I appreciate the faith. Jay says, only a real woman can grow a beard with such style as Taylor Swift. True that, Jay. True that. Totally agree. Meryl, you used to have long hair back in the day. Why'd you cut it? Oh, you did Google that means. Well, let's just put it this way. Like, at this stage in my life, it's cutting itself. So, you know, you ever see somebody who's like balding a little bit who has a ponytail? Just doesn't look right. So cut it short. Let me see. Is it okay if it becomes just too orange? Just say it was a... Right, exactly. You know, everybody spray tans. That's a good point. Let me refresh, see if there's any more questions or comments. And then I'm going to put finishing touches. Thank you for the 43 likes. Oh, here we go. Skunk FU25. Hey, Meryl, one last question before I go to bed. Will you be posting this video on YouTube, but sped up? Yes. Yes, I will. The plan for this is I'm going to do two separate I'm going to do a step-by-step, but one is going to be with pencil. One is going to be with paint. So Miss Swift gets two different step-by-steps, I guess. Excuse me. I'm going to be posting this as a step-by-step video, definitely. All right. All right, so I'm going to put the finishing touches. There's just a little bit left to do. And if I really want to go OCD, I could let it dry, and then I can do another coat on top. And believe me, with painting, it's addictive. You have to tell yourself to stop sometimes. But, you know, there's these little edits that you notice. Like, for instance, right now I'm noticing there's a difference in tone between her eyebrow that's here and the one in the picture. But I think the likeness is there, like in my own style. I've never been able to get like photorealism. I've lost the desire to do that. I like, I don't know. I like the uniqueness that each person's hand, you know, brings. All right, so let's finish this. Let's go back to the pencils. And let's carve right into the hair. So you could still color it. You could still detail it. Soften the areas that you want. All right, about to wrap up. Okay, we're gonna call this finished for tonight. I'm gonna think about this. I'm gonna look at it again tomorrow and see if there's gonna be a third hangout, and I'll try to have this done. I have the steps done already on the step-by-step, but I'll try to have the video out by Wednesday night. But right now I'll go to webcam and I'll answer a few questions and then we go to bed, watch The Walking Dead, you know, whatever. Hey, that rhymed. I didn't mean that. Okay. So let me just move my stuff. And any questions you guys have, I will answer them. So let me just switch. Oh, and I have to plug my computer in, it says. There we go. Still here. Ooh, I look tired. Oh, well. Any questions you guys have? I'm here. hit me up. Let me go to the questions. I've been enjoying doing these live streams. Hey, what's up, active artist? Jay, I agree with you. Hard edges, soft edges. Welcome back, Skunk FU25. Welcome back, Blitz 145. Too bad YouTube doesn't have a recap of the comments on these live vids. Yep. Hey, Merrill, one last question before I go to bed. Oh, I answered that already. I can't read. Active artist, it was just, I'm going to have the whole thing up, but I did a layer of illustration markers, then I did a layer of colored pencil, and I did oil paint on top of that. That was an old comment. Let me see. Want to learn how to do that, Shadow Katsumi Princess? You are well along your way. Keep going in your sketchbook. Do it on your own terms. Stay with your interests. If portraiture interests you, I think my channel is a good way to get you from, you know, step A to, you're not at step A, you're beyond that, but, you know, to the end of intermediate. And there's a lot of really, really good channels that are coming out right now. I like that guy, Proko, I think his name is. He's really good. And whatchamacallit, I just got an email from him today. Let me check my channel. What's his name? Italian accent. His name's Leonardo. Really, really good artist. But those guys can give you some good finishing details. Bear with me. The name of his channel, Fine Art Tips. Great name for a channel. Yeah, he's got something like 300,000 subscribers, and good reason why. What is the meaning of life? Man. It's a cereal. No. Meaning of life? Yes, I'm going to answer that seriously. I think you got to know that... that you gave something, that you left your imprint on the world. And, you know, I don't know. You guys give that to me, so thank you, as do all of my students that I see in class on a daily basis. You know, that's what's kind of cool about teaching. You know, you get to leave an imprint on people. I love having this venue, you know, as a means to... teach. So to me, that's the meaning of life. Mr. Magic King loves Proko. Yeah, no, great. Da Vinci, right, that's right. Yeah, he put me in his channel box today and vice versa. I have a question. The paper you're using, how much does it warp? It doesn't at all. Let me show you without, I could actually take this off. This is the paper that I use. Let me, hold on. Yeah, this is the paper that I use. It is Borden and Riley. And it's bleed-proof paper. Good stuff. All right. Let's get back to those comments. You're welcome. He donated to your Indiegogo. Love that guy. That's awesome. Yeah, I've heard really good stuff about him. All right, you guys have any more questions? Let me see what time it is. Wow, only 10:04, finished early. Another lady, even though I always say I don't like photorealism, I admire it. Heather Rooney, wow, amazing, really amazing. I didn't know you could do that with colored pencils. I'm just being honest, like insane with the colored pencils. What's up, Mohit? Dang, I just used some cheapo sketch pad from Walmart, but it does the job. That's it. You need something that, you know, it does the job. This I only use because these markers, like with regular paper, they like bleed all over the place. So you kind of need something with that. It gives you better control. Wasn't that expensive. It was something like $7. How often do you take breaks when you're working on an art piece? Oh, that good question. I don't know. Some of them just flow. Some of them, it's like forced, totally forced. So the ones that are forced, I take a lot of breaks. The ones that flow, you know, I don't. All right, guys, anything else? I see there's still about 15 people out there. Give you a minute to write those final questions. Did I get paint on me? I think I did right here. Oh, well. All right, folks, I guess that's a day. Yeah, thank you guys so much. Cool, 44 likes, thank you. Oh, here we go. Is there like a good pencil that you recommend for a nice graduated tone of shading? Not really. I'm blanking on the name of the brand that I always use. And they actually endorsed me. Oops. But I don't really see too much difference in pencils. A number two pencil is an HB pencil. I don't know. Maybe that's just me, but I kind of just feel the pencil's a pencil. Do you ever give up on a piece? Good question. No, I morph it. Like there's stuff like that has meant to be something else, and I just go mad scientist. That's my rule. Like whenever I do something, I go mad scientist until I get somewhere with it. Yeah. Hunter Roseberry just finished his Rick Ross, right on. If you want, oh man, there's no more video responses. See, I'm outdated now. Like I was like, yeah, post is a video response. Great. If you want, post it to the Facebook page. You know, I'll definitely, you know, put it up there. You know, reshare it with everybody else. That's awesome. Or if you want to take a quick picture or video now, send it to my email. I'll put it at the end of this video. I've used printer paper. Right on. Cheap and cost effective. I only use this paper like when I'm doing something this detailed. All right. Might come on tomorrow night. I'm going to take a look at it. I really go OCD. And I really want to show you guys what paint can do.
I'm happy with it. I think that it's a likeness of Taylor Swift, but like you could really take it to another level, especially if you glaze. Maybe that's your homework. I've got a glazing video that shows you what glazing can do to a work of art, and maybe I'll do some glazing and show you how to do that tomorrow. But I'm going to give it a good look, see what my schedule looks like, because like my work schedule gets pretty busy too. Knowing me, I'll glaze. Just go mad scientist with it. Yes, absolutely. I swear one time I was like trying to draw my mother and it turned into, I don't even remember what it turned into, but it was like a gangster or something. But you go with it. Yeah. Have fun with it. Sent it to the Facebook. Awesome. It doesn't have to be bobbleheaded. Not at all. You still using the huge printer you bought? Oh man, this past like year and a half of my life, Jay, I'm telling you. I haven't, but I intend to. I'm happy to be making the comeback. Let me show you the printer. Can you guys see that? Sitting right next to me. It's like ginormous. And I bought it like with my first few checks that I got from YouTube. And that was kind of like my moment of celebration. Could you guys all see that? You see it in the background right now. But I have underused it, I'm sad to say. I'm thinking that this is a better way to do it though, like to do some live art. I like the number of people. I hope it kind of, in all honesty, stays 15 to 20, because like you could keep up with the comments. There's no like super fast pace. Mohit says, mother of God. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. And it is just, my wife lets me know about it all the time. She's like, you don't use the printer. And I'm like, I will. Darn it. I will. Whenever I post my own art on YouTube, it gets like 1/10 of the views that everything else does. But yeah, again, I've said it to you guys. It's not all about that. If you have a vision for something, you just you do it. You make sure that it's done. Holy crap, that's a printer we use at work. Massive. Yeah. I think that Epson has like a whole series, or I'm sorry, Hewlett-Packard, what am I saying, has a whole series just made for artists. And I don't know, it's meant to help me out with my mixed media, but it's been underused. We're going to fix that. Yeah, you know what? Maybe next hangout, I will be using that. I think next week I'm going to draw Mark Crilly step by step. Maybe right after that, I'm going to just do a mixed media piece. And maybe if you guys worked at the same time and like you, I don't know, we'll have to find a way that you guys can like post or, you know, send it. Couldn't imagine using it at home. Use it a lot of work for work at drafting jobs. Yeah. Exactly. I totally agree, Jay. Yep. I'll be like, ha! I'm seeing we're up to 17 now. Let me just do a quick switch back from webcam to this. so that they can see. There might be a part three, there might not. I'm happy with the likeness. But if you glaze it, you take it to the next level. And I kind of want to show you guys that. Have you ever done digital paintings? Digital, no. Tradigital, yes. Tradigital is kind of like my own thing. Part of it is because I'm so darn inept with digital stuff. But, you know, I've taught myself PaintShop Pro, and I would collage PaintShop Pro. You know, I would do a photo collage, then I'd print, and then I would paint on top of the photo collage. And that's really what I bought this for. But then I get promotions at work and all these new responsibilities and children and exactly. Uh-oh, hold on. Oh, it's still, okay. All right. So I guess, you know, for tonight, that's it. Might be on again tomorrow night. Really enjoying my comeback to YouTube. It's fun. You know, thank you guys for joining me and, you know, taking the time to watch. Instead of The Walking Dead, like, I feel absolutely honored. So thank you for that. And stay tuned. More videos coming. I'm going to have the step-by-step of Taylor Swift out, I think, by Wednesday. And next weekend, I think I'm going to do Mr. Mark Crilly. Okay? Everybody have a good night. And see you very soon, maybe tomorrow.